Hey everybody, Andrew here, and today I'm gonna be showing you how to take your wheels from looking nasty and dirty and full of brake dust to looking like brand new. Let's get into it. So all you're gonna need to do this is a couple of things. You're gonna need the Adams Polishes wheel cleaner or their wheel and tire cleaner. You're gonna need their turbo stick cleaning brush for your drill. It's a really awesome attachment and absolutely makes this process take about half the time. I also like to use one of their wheel cleaning brushes just to help get around the lug nuts and all those little hard to reach places. And then you're also going to need a bucket full of soapy water. So the first thing you need to do to start out this process is to wash your wheels off with the hose. Now, I actually like to start with the wheels on my truck. I like to do that before I do any of the paint, and I use a fully separate bucket for that. The reason I like to do the wheels first is that way, once I'm done washing the truck, I can dry everything immediately. You're not trying to race to do your wheels while the water dries on your paint. So I always like to do the wheels first, and that's the first thing I tackle. So this is a hideous set of wheels, but I chose it for this video because it has a really deep barrel. So it's actually pretty hard to clean and reach back all the way in there. And that's where that turbo stick is gonna come in really handy. The next step is you're gonna take the Adams wheel cleaner or the wheel and tire cleaner. In this video, I'm gonna be using the wheel cleaner, and we're gonna be spraying down the wheel. And that stuff is gonna actually activate with the brake dust that's on your wheel. So what brake dust really is a lot of iron, right? There's iron actually bonded to the wheel on the paint. Or if you have like a raw finish wheel, it will bond to that. The reason why is that brake dust is hot, right? So it sticks to the paint and really binds to it. So what you need is something to chemically break it down and release it from that bond that it has with the paint. Now, one word of warning is if you do have a raw finish aluminum wheel, like an American Force wheel or something like that, you probably don't wanna be using this wheel cleaner, or you wanna test it just to make sure that it doesn't mess up the finish. On some of those anodized finished or raw finish wheels, some of these cleaners can interact with them depending on how the finish is. So just do a little test spot, and if you're worried at all, just skip straight to using a microfiber wash mitt with just the standard Adams car wash soap. Now that we have this wheel sprayed down, you're gonna start to see the reaction happening. Now this wheel isn't quite as bad. Again, you just can't see it because it's black, but that wheel cleaner will start to turn purple as it reacts with the iron. There's a few places here where you can see it, and you can also see it kind of dripping off onto the ground, but it's hard to see in that black finish. So once you see that reaction start to happen, let it take its place. You just wanna make sure that it doesn't dry on the wheel. So maybe let it sit about 5-6 minutes. I'll usually spray down two wheels at a time, and I can be working on both of those at the same time. That way, you know, you can run back and forth between one and the other, and it gets the process done a little bit faster. Now, once you see that reaction starting to take place, you're going to take your turbo stick on your drill, you're gonna dip it in that bucket of soapy water, and you're gonna start going to town on the wheel. I typically like to start in the back at the barrel, and I'll use that turbo stick in there to get in all the little nooks and crannies, reach all the way back into the edge of that wheel. It does an amazing job of reaching places that you just can't get with your hand, especially in wheels that have a more closed spoke design. You can pass it through that little hole and get all the way into the barrel of the wheel and keep that clean. And that's usually the place that gets the most damage, right? Because people clean it the least. And so you get the most brake dust buildup and the most bonded brake dust into there. So it's a really good place to clean to keep your wheels looking nice. Next, you're gonna move outward and clean the outer lip and barrel of the wheel. Then you're gonna grab either the microfiber wash mitt or the Adams wheel brush, and you're gonna start cleaning the little nooks and crannies of the wheel, right? So around your lug nuts, all the spokes, every place that's hard to get with that turbo stick, the faces of the wheel, things like that. So you're gonna get all that stuff nice and clean. Then you're gonna go through and hose it all off and get all the dirt and crud off of your wheel. Now to dry, my personal favorite is to use the Adams Sidekick Blaster. It's a small little air blaster that lets you really get in there without any real work. You can pretty much dry off your lug nuts, dry off your tires, dry all the little nooks and crannies of the wheel, and then you can go back in with a microfiber and mop things up. If you don't have one of those, don't worry. You can just use a standard microfiber or whatever towel you have laying around. I like microfibers because they don't mar the finish. So that's one big thing, is that a lot of wheels like this gloss black, it's really easy to mar the finish. So you wanna be delicate with that and make sure you're using a very soft wheel brush if you're using a wheel brush, or a microfiber wheel cleaning mitt. And then you're gonna go back and use a microfiber towel. Now, these towels and everything that I use on the wheels, I don't use anywhere else in the truck, right? These microfibers are just for my wheels. They do get dirty. You know, those little spots that I miss and stuff, and you don't want any of that stuff on the paint. So everything that's on the wheel stays for the wheels only. And then you are good to go. Your wheel should be looking fantastic. One extra thing you can do is, you know, obviously I like to put on some sort of tire dressing. I have another video, I will link it at the end of this video and in the description, you can watch for the tire armor. It's about a 2 month coating, so it lasts for 2 months. So I really like that stuff, and it's a fantastic option if you want something that will last a little bit longer and leave a nice shine on your tires. So I hope this helped you guys. If you're looking to clean your wheels, this will work for very stubborn wheels. Even if you have a very neglected set of wheels, something like this wheel cleaner will really work to chemically break down that bonded brake dust and remove it from the wheel surface so you have a nice clean finish. This is something that you want to do every time you wash your car so that your wheels stay looking good. It's one of those places that I always see people get lazy on, and it really makes a difference. So please let me know if you guys have any other videos you want me to do. Leave it in the comments below. Thank you so much for watching, and stay tuned because we will be posting a video every week. So don't forget to hit that subscribe button. Thank you so much, guys, and I'll catch you in the next one.